my learner profile, and we're going to start with the big picture. And this is my notes of Nicole, who was a guest speaker from Nepal. I actually didn't find pictures of her speaking to us, so I just took a picture of my notes. And during the presentation of her speaking to us, she was talking about how, like, the weather doesn't really cooperate well in the location she was at in Nepal, and how there's really bad, there's severe bacteria in the water, which makes all the people like hydrated, because dehydrated, most of the people are dehydrated in that area, and most women wouldn't drink a glass of water a day, and drinking like a gallon a day for people in the U.S. is like average, so it's kind of, oh yeah, so the learner profile that it brought me to was the awareness and empathy, because I'm very fortunate to live in a place where I don't have to worry about the water, where I can just rely on the turn of a faucet, and yeah, so I kind of want to get the word about how the water crisis is really bad, and how the kids still there, she said, are very, they're still very resourceful, and she said that all the kids will still have a smile on their face, so, yeah. So, yeah, it's kind of made me feel a lot, to not take things for granted, and sorry if the pictures are small on this side, so I'll start with this one, and this one's the Professor Alex Golub came to speak with us about when he was in Papua New Guinea, and there's no picture, unfortunately, so I had to just take a picture of my notes. And all the people in Papua New Guinea, the water is just the same as Nepal. It's really bad, and they don't have a great source, and I can't scroll into it. All the, people at Papua New Guinea, he pointed out a lot of interesting facts that I really didn't know about, that there's a lot of people, they don't really have a clean drinking source, and 1 out of 10 people have somewhat of a phone, a decent phone, and but the people there are still very energetic and happy every day, he said, and life is just, they didn't really care about the water, they just wanted to be happy, and that's another, I'm bringing it up again about the awareness and empathy and the awareness that this water crisis is actually, it's actually really big, and we need to like do something, and yeah, I just kind of feel really bad for them, because I just wish I was there to help them out in some way. And this is our, okay, this is our mobilum, and yeah, and by the time we were working on mobilum, we already had a pretty good source about the water in Papua New Guinea, so this actually took a lot of collaboration, because each group member needed to do their fair share of work, and this also needed a lot of creativity, like how are we going to make ours stand out from others, because others would just maybe draw with Sharpie, but we decided to paint ours, which no one else did, so I thought that was really, it stood out, because we have a lot of colors in ours, and it's very vibrant. And this one is our, this is our infographic. This one's our infographic for the bond, shared bonds. I don't have a picture of it, but so I just took a picture of my notes again. And bonds are, the bond, what I learned about bonds is how important they are to our lives, and if there are no bonds, we wouldn't be living today. And our bonds, they're really important to us every day, and we learn many new types of bonds, like covalent ionic and hydrogen. Like without hydrogen, we wouldn't have H2O. Without ionic, we wouldn't have toothpaste, which are daily things we use. And the data that I learned, so I got the data from that and applied it to new problems, which would be like what we can make more out of, which is bonds. And my last one was the water testing, where we just took different sensors and just tested water. And at first it was actually really hard, because I wouldn't know how to calibrate it, or I wouldn't calibrate it at first, so our results would be all mixed up and you'd have to restart. So that's when you have to have a positive mindset going into each thing. You can't just think negative, saying that, well, I'm going to do bad on this, or just because I'm going to do bad. You need to go in with a positive mindset, because the outcome will most likely be that you'll learn something out of it. And so I didn't really like give up, and I just kept on learning how to use the sensors and probes. I think having a positive mindset is really important. Okay, that's it.